starting with the FC-200V calculator. The calculator that is needed is FC-200V. It is the only calculator that you can use as a financial consultant. The functions that we will be telling you is only related to this calculator. In case you're using any other, please follow the user manual of the same. And also check whether the calculator is allowed in the examination that is prescribed by FPSB or not. Talking about FC-200V, I will give you a brief introduction of how do we operate this calculator and how do we basically start working on it. Then we will be following the concepts as in wise. So the point of schedule will remain. I will cover the topic, that is, I will tell you, I will teach you the topic, and in case the calculator functions are needed in it, I will tell you the same side by side, right? So calculator, how do we operate this? Let us understand what the calculator basically is. So these are basically this row and this row remains most important as we will be using these functions. CMPD is compounding function, cash function, amortization function, then this is convert function. So these are the primarily functions that we will be using used in CFP. So talking about this fourth row, which is this subtract sign is not exactly subtract. This is basically signifies that this is minus 78. It is not plus 78, it is minus 78. It is basically, it denotes the negative side of the timeline, right? Then we have important function of store and recall. This is function where in case I want to store this figure itself and then use it ever after in all answers, or maybe it is quite oftenly used, or maybe the answer is so difficult that I can't write it exact, or maybe it's too lengthy to be written and used correctly. Maybe it has a lot of decimal places which I don't want to write, right? In that case, how do we operate this? Shift is basically shift, and then it is used to operate all the buttons that are, all the things that are mentioned above your buttons. So hence we get this store function. Then you have shortcut 1 and shortcut 2. This shortcut is basically the most often figure that you generally use in your figures. You can store it here. Otherwise, you have A, B, C, D, E, F. You have a lot of figures here. You can just simply go here, execute. Execute is inserting the figure. He will ask you whether you want to overwrite. In case I have already written, he will ask you overwrite. In case you are storing for the first time, he will ask you store. Then you press execute in case you want to go ahead and store. In case you aren't willing to do that, you press escape, right? We pre-press execute. It clearly shows you that minus 78 is now punched in as A. In case I want to use this figure, how do I use it is, now suppose 123 minus, now I want to use that figure. Store was the inverse function where I needed to use shift and then store. But at the time of recall, I simply press recall. He will ask me which recall, A, B, C, D, where did you, you inserted that figure. You will press A, execute. And now you will get your answer is 201, because your answer was 123 minus 78. Hence, minus and minus, it became positive, and your answer is now as 201. Right? I hope that we are clear with this fact. This is percentage sign above. Again, same point, shift and then percentage. Exactly. So execute. It is like 2.01. 201 divided by 100. It has 201 is shifted, is now used as the percentage. Then here is the comma. These are the functions for statistical use. Right? This row is very clear, simple row, numbers have been punched in. This is the normal calculator functions that every calculator has. Now, in case you are using functions like you want to clear memory of any function, you will simply CMPD say shift 9. It says clear. It says clear setup, clear memory, yeah, all, clear everything. Or it has different other things also that you can just go and in whatever that you want to delete, you can use this function and delete. And I would say memory, or I would say all. And then I will go simply and press execute button. He will ask me, yes, reset all. I would say, yes, reset all. Reset all, press AC key to just return back. Right? Now, You see, in case you you press CMPD, all the parts of this function is cleared except for these are the default. They have to be, they're set in such a manner. This is the default that settings that have already been done. Now, so after the basic functions, we know what is shift and what does it do. We know how to clear the memory of the calculator. The important part now is setup. Now, setup is used for generally date mode. We don't use it much, but date mode is how many number of days there are. In money market instruments, we generally use a convention of 360 days and not 365. So there you can come here and change the number of days in case you're using particularly for such function where 360 is used instead of 365. We basically need to check here is the number of fix is what we are looking for. Fix is basically decimal places. In case I want there are certain cases where I would say that please punch you know, your answer should be at least two decimal places or at least four decimal places. There you can use this function. Come here, fix. This is, you can fix 0 to 9. This means you can punch in any, and you can, you know, use 4 digit, 5 digit, 7 digit decimal places as well. So the more number of digits you use, the more accuracy you enhance in your answer, right? So in case I say I want a decimal places up to 3 places, so this is fix 3. Now in case you come out and use this function, this is already 3 decimal places that is showing here. So this is basically the primary introduction of your calculator. We are moving ahead with the timelines and how do we draw that.